Hello guys, my name is Adil and you are watching the Biomed Dude. In this video, I will discuss about the defibrillator machine. I have a complete demonstration and presentation of that, so let's get started. So guys, I am on screen now. Here is the content. Firstly, we will discuss about the introduction, then the type of the defibrillator, after that the type of electrodes, working principle of the defibrillator, operating guides, how to operate this machine, and then external part of the defibrillator, and after that I will show you the internal part of the defibrillator. So there are three different types of defibrillator which are commonly used, and then introduction of the defibrillator. Introduction of the defibrillator. A defibrillator is a device that sends electrical energy or shock to the heart. The conversion of a ventricular arrhythmia is to a normal rhythm by an electrical shock is called defibrillation. So they are used to prevent or correct an arrhythmia, a heartbeat that is uneven or that is too slow or too fast. Defibrillator can also restore the heart beating if the heart suddenly stops. A defibrillator uses moderately high voltage between 200 and 1000 volt to shock the heart with, sessionally reset the SA node and force it to resume the normal electrical activity. So here is the different types of the defibrillator. So first one is the manual external defibrillator, manual internal defibrillator, semi-automatic external defibrillator, automatic external defibrillator or AED, implantable cardioverter defibrillator or ICD, and the last one is wearable cardiac defibrillators. So I will explain all the types in individually one by one. So the first type of the defibrillator is manual external defibrillators. These defibrillators require more experience and training to efficiently handle them. In conjunction with ECG, the trained provide determine the cardiac rhythm and then manually determine the voltage and time of the shock through external pedal to the patient chest. A defibrillator which applies an electrical shock to the patient surface cardiac arrest required direct. Here is the three different pictures doing the CPR to the patient, then we adjust the jowl as per requirement and shock to the patient as per requirement. So here is manual internal defibrillator where we use the internal pedal like these types. On the previous defibrillator we use the external pedals like these types, and on internal we'll use these types of pedals. The manual internal defibrillator use internal pedal to send the electrical shock direct to the heart. It's mostly used on the theaters or cardiac surgery open chest. So they are only common in the operating room. It was invented in 1959. Next type of the defibrillator is semi-automatic external defibrillator. Semi-automatic external defibrillator analyze the heart rhythm, and if a abnormal heart rhythm is detected that required a shock, then an device promote the user to press the button or deliver to the defibrillator shock. Here are two different semi-automatic and fully automatic defibrillation mode. The next one is automatic external defibrillator. Automatic external defibrillator or AED. These are defibrillator that use computer technology, thereby making it easy to analyze the heart rhythm and effectively determine the rhythm in shockable. As AED are considered public access device that can be used by anyone, whether trained or untrained. They can be found in medical facility, government offices, airport, hotel, sports stadium and the school as well. So here is the complete picture to provide a shock through AED. Here is different companies AED. So the next type is implantable cardioverter defibrillator. Another name of this automatic internal defibrillator, cardiac defibrillator or AICD. IDC are placed surgically in the chest or abdomen where it checks arrhythmias. IDC have a generator connected to the wire to detect the heart pulses and deliver to the shock when needed. So the next type is wearable cardiac defibrillator, which is belt type and connect to the patient. So this device is capable for monitoring the patient 24 hours a day. The device have sensor that attach to the skin. This device has a belt attachment to vest and worn under your cloth. So this device can also send a record to the activity to your doctor. So the next topic is type of electrode for defibrillator. So these are different three types of pedals or electrode which is used for defibrillations. So first one is spoon shape electrode applied directly to the heart. These type are internal defibrillator type pedals or electrode. So the second one is pedal type electrode which is used skin surfaces. And third one is pad type electrode which is used directly to the chest wall. So the working principle of the defibrillator. Defibrillator deliver direct electrical current across the cardiac muscles with the aim to converting a diarrhythmia into normal sine rhythm. It is used to treat ventricular fibrillation, which is one of the main causes of sudden deaths. Here is the block diagram of the defibrillator where we can easily understand how the defibrillator works. Here is the display LCD main controller system and the power supply give the voltage to the main controller and the generator IV and storage energy. Here is the protection and discharge solution and here is electrode which deliver the shock to the patients. So the second block diagram also explain how it's charge and discharge the energy. So the first one is power supply, then a charging button through the switch controller and the energy storage device like a capacitor or a battery. Mostly the energy store in the capacitors. So here is standby mode. If we want to discharge them on the patient, then we a gate pass and then the patient where the energy will be delivered. So ECG monitoring continuously, then the timing circuitry continuous monitoring and deliver the shock as per requirement. So these are the method. So the amount of the charge that is discharged on the defibrillator is to current multiplied by the time. 12 ampere multiply by 0.01 second, which gives 0.12 coulombs of charge. So electron volt change in the energy by moving a single electron across in the electrical potential different of the voltage. 1 electron volt is equal to this 1 joules. So here is the two different technique which is used for the defibrillation, like monophasic and biphasic. Currently the biphasic technology used. Here is the curve which delivered the single one direction current and here is the bidirectional two current delivered in the two directionals. So operation procedure for the defibrillator. Step 1, turn on the defibrillator. These are the different steps to operate the defibrillator. Turn on the defibrillators and peel the sticky pad attachment and to the patient's skin. Once the paddle have been attached, stop CPR or don't touch the patient. The defibrillator will access whether a shockable or not. An automatic defibrillator will shock the patient without prompt. And the fifth one is the defibrillator will when the shock can be delivered or not, whether the need is continuous CPR or not. Step 5-6, continue the chest compression and rescue breathe until the patient show sign of the defibrillator. Defibrillator tell you the stop or you can analyze the heartbeat again. These are the steps to deliver the shock to the patient. So guys, here is a picture of defibrillator where display the different indications. The purpose of this switch like turn on the equipment button, alarm indicator, battery indicator, battery charging indicator, and NABP, printer, scan, disposable mount, defibrillator charge command, enable, disable AED mode, like different switches for different procedures. So I'm just explain you the external part of the defibrillator. Here is the Nihon Coden defibrillator, where here is the connection of the pedals. These are the two pedals. Here is the connection of the pedals. Here is the shock switch, and here is the AED charging switch. So this is a knob for selection of jowl and deliver to the patient as per our requirements, and other modes to operate this defibrillator. Here is two different pedals, epic and sternum. Here is the charging indication hand, and here is two discharge indications and switches. So now I am talking about the internal parts of the defibrillators. Here is the main screen board and main PCB board, one of the defibrillator. Here is the internal structure of the defibrillator, and here is the high voltage HV panel where charge and discharge to the patients. On the next screen, here is the front panel of the defibrillator. Here is the inside of the panel defibrillator. Here is the battery chambers, and here is the knob, speaker, and other switches. Thank you.